Tejano Outlaw Radio.com. What's up, mi raza? Muy buenas tardes. Minutes away. We are just minutes away for another worldwide exclusive interview with the king of Tejano music, the legendary icon, Mr. Joe Lopez. He'll be calling here in the studio in just a few minutes. Shout outs going out to all of you. Right about this time, also, I am on Facebook Live. Shout outs going out to all of you who are jumping on for this exclusive interview. Joe Lopez.
Fui ciego con tu amor, es la verdad. Las veces que decías que me querías, mis ojos no vieron la realidad. Con nadie tú tendrás lo que conmigo. Y nadie te amará como te amo yo. Tu cuerpo y mi cuerpo era uno solo. Y ahora tú tendrás que estar sin mí. Cuando tú te me vayas, sabrás lo que has perdido. Jurabas que me querías, sabiendo que eran mentiras. Cuando tú te me vayas, comprenderás lo que has hecho, tan solo por tus mentiras. Ya no estaré a tu lado. Tendrás lo que conmigo, y nadie te amará como te amo yo. Tu cuerpo y mi cuerpo era uno solo, y ahora tú tendrás que estar sin mí. Cuando tú te me vayas, sabrás lo que has perdido. Jurabas que me querías, sabiendo que eran mentiras. Cuando tú te me vayas, comprenderás lo que has perdido. Tan solo por tus mentiras, ya no estaré a tu lado.
Tejano Outlaw Radio.com. Oh, yeah. Muy buenas tardes. Shout outs going out to all of you hanging out with us right here. It's your boy DJ Casper once again. Doing it a little bit something like this. Shout outs going out to all of you hanging out with us once again. All right, let me see here. I'm getting some.
You're dying on it.
Hombre. Give them mouth to mouth, Sandra. Give them mouth to mouth.
No, you are.
No, I'm just like really, really nervous.
Come on,
man. I know I've been doing this just as long as Joe, man. But anytime it's something like this, very, very important, man. You know, los nervios. All of a sudden, they just jump up from behind. Muy buenas noches, Joe Lopez, Sandro Vallejo, from an undisclosed area aquí en el estado de Texas. ¿Cómo estamos?
Muy bien, gracias a Dios. Saludos para ti, DJ Casper, y para todo Tejano Outlaw Radio que están escuchando a través de la radio. And happy Valentine's Day to all those fans out there celebrating their day-to-day and lovers lanes out there. Happy Valentine's.
¿Cómo has estado, brother? Last time we spoke, man, I know, you were doing your tour. You were actually going all over radios and doing the calls and all of that. ¿Cómo has estado?
Yo estoy muy bien, gracias a Dios, de salud. Estoy muy bien y me siento contento por todo lo que está pasando, ¿verdad? Yo nada más quería también darte las gracias por darme la oportunidad de nuevamente saludar al público y recordándole a todos que we must educate our children, especially our male children. Los Hispanics are number one right now for wrongful sexual assaults and teenager right now, the kids, they're sitting in prison, and yo nada más quería mandar un saludo para a todos esos que nos están escuchando y llamar la atención a los padres que cuiden mucho a los hijos y los eduquen, porque esto es the Hispanics are number one, and they were wrongfully sexually abused, and that's not the sexually assaulted, I'm sorry, and that's not right.
Now, let's go ahead and inform our listeners what you're talking about. As we know, you were wrongfully accused of a charge, and you lived 10 years away from society due to being accused, wrongfully accused. And now that you're out, now that you're out and you're free, and almost free, porque I know you have a lot of things going on, and if you'd like to disclose any information, it's all on you, brother. But I know we want to educate. The purpose of this call is to educate, a lot of people that don't know that, you know, it's easy for somebody to pick up the phone and say, hey, me hicieron esto, hey, que este es el otro. And the consequences that people go through, and you know, unfortunately for you, you lived it. And so, you know, pretty much, you know, explain to our fans and listeners what are other things that they can go about reversing this, and what's the next step. I know Sandra Vallejo's been doing a lot of things out there in Austin, Texas, and so just let the listeners know, brother.
Well, that's it. So Sandra's been doing a lot, and she just got back from the Capitol a few days ago, hablando de lo mismo.
Yes, Casper, you know, I was there lobbying because there are a lot of things that need to be changed. For one, we need to educate our Hispanic culture.
Mm-hmm.
We do not have the funds, the resources that others may have to protect our children. Mm-hmm. And I'm not talking $100 or $500, Casper. Mm-hmm. I'm talking just for an attorney to take a sexual assault case these days. You're looking at $20,000-$30,000 just to walk into a courtroom to say, I'm representing you. Mm-hmm. That doesn't mean that's all it's going to cost.
Mm-hmm.
But my job and Joe's, what we're doing here is to educate. If we can prevent one family from going through what Joe has gone through and many others, then we're doing our job. If we don't stand up and protect our culture, then most of our young children who we protect are going to be sitting in prison simply because they might have touched their girlfriend inappropriately and their parent didn't like it.
Mm-hmm.
Well, if that person was a minor, that individual is going to be charged with a sexual assault charge. So mm-hmm. I say this to males, to all of you young males who are out there. I have a son
mm-hmm.
who's 38 years old, Casper, and mm-hmm. today I tell him, you take care of yourself. If you see a woman that's drunk out there, that she's falling down, in the past we raised him to go and help a female.
Oh, you can't even do that. You can't even do that.
These days, you can't do that.
No.
Because if that female opens her eyes and you're trying to pick her up,
it's something else. Yes, it's something totally, something else. Yep. Mm-hmm.
And that's what society has brought. This is what the legislature has made this case, this offense to be. So we as parents cannot protect our children and say, oh, we want you to respect every woman out there. I'm a woman, Casper,
mm-hmm.
but I can tell you what, there are some vindictive, spiteful females out there that choose to ruin males' lives just because they didn't get to stay with you or that male went with another woman.
Yes.
It's got to stop.
Yes.
And they know that the laws are sided for them.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I tell you what, females that are out there being spiteful and vindictive, my law is that if you falsely allege and we find out that you falsely allege, by the time I stop breathing, there is going to be a law at the Capitol that states you will go serve that prison time.
Nope.
It is out of control, Casper. There are many men, mm-hmm. innocent young children that are sitting in prison because the law allows the females to do this, and it's time to make a change.
Now, let me ask you this, Sandra, since you've made it down to Austin, what is the procedure now? Are people, Is the people there actually listening now? Because, I mean, it's been going, haven't been reported for so many years. A lot of people get away with it, como has dicho. And they're so quick to pick up the phone and, y como les dije, oh, he touched me the wrong way, y ese que el otro. Are people actually listening? What is it that we need to do? I know right now we're on worldwide news. I mean, this is not just happening here in Texas. It's happening in every single city in the States across the nation. What is something that we need to, what message, and what's going to unify the people to take a stand for what happened to Joel?
Well, the first thing we have to do is we can't stay quiet. Our culture tends to shy down and not have a voice because we haven't been practicing to preach that because our parents raised us to be respectful young adults. But nowadays, Casper, you must get out there. You must show your face. You must get to those doors that are closing on you. And you have to repeatedly continue to fight. Mm-hmm. Do not take no for an answer. Mm-hmm. You must show the evidence. If you are wrongfully convicted and you have evidence, don't sit there and let your lawyer run the show. Mm-hmm. You must speak out. If you don't speak and you didn't say something, then you know what? When your case is closed, it's all on you because you didn't voice that.
Mm-hmm.
And I tell you this because I've been doing this for almost 28 years now.
Mm-hmm.
The most important thing is to always show up, to be there, support your family. Don't send them by themselves to court. Don't send them alone to the attorney's office. It takes a to get through something this heavy. This crime, the sexual assault charge, is horribly horrifying, and it's devastating to a family, Casper. It ruins your life. It takes all your resources. It puts you in a welfare line. It puts you with nothing, out in the street. And the government needs to look at what they've done.
Mm-hmm. So now, have you heard of any foundations that's actually opening up for this special cause? Because I mean, I know it's gonna take a lot from, especially a lot of taxpayers are gonna pay out of pocket for all these programs as well. These governments, they need to provide something for these families that can't afford, you know, legal representation.
I'm glad you brought that up, Casper, because there is not one foundation out there that will fork up the whole entire bill of your case. Now, I am a part of a foundation, an organization that's called Texas Voices.
Mm-hmm.
Texas Voices is founded by Mary Sue Molnar. What a wonderful, beautiful lady that resides in San Antonio, Texas.
Mm-hmm.
Full of information. Her meeting that she has provides anybody and everybody with practice letters to send to your representative, to send to your legislators, anybody that has and is able to make a change.
Mm-hmm.
If you do not communicate to your representatives, your senators that live in your district, and voice your opinion, they're not going to budge.
Okay.
And I can tell you right now, there are very few their head out for a sexual assault charge.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because then it's going to make them look like they're defending predators. But we must. The leaders of our capital must open their eyes
now,
because they've done damage to families.
Exactly. And a lot of people do not understand, you know, Joel Lopez being a Tejano icon, okay, in the industry. And he was a high-profile case. You know, if it wasn't for you and the people that helped you to bring this to the law attention, Joel would probably still be sitting there, correct?
Joe was not even going to be paroled. We were very, very fortunate to be able to attain Bill Haburn.
Mm-hmm.
Bill Haburn worked his tail off 28 weeks to get Joe paroled on his first parole. Mm-hmm. I can tell you right now, Casper, Joe was not going to be coming out.
Wow.
And it's very sad that he would have continued to live in prison for something that he did not do.
So basically, by the grace of God and the right people that reached out and helped you, he's here with us now. Joel, ¿cómo te sientes? Joe, ¿estás escuchando? ¿Cómo te sientes, bro?
Me siento muy contento ahorita porque estoy aquí en me siento que tengo un poquito de libertad, pero siempre todo lo que me hicieron es algo que me lo llevo por dentro. Me ha lastimado mucho a mí, a mi familia, a mi madre, que es la que más me interesa, más me importa, ¿verdad? Pero ojalá que la que me haya acusado algún día la metan a ella a la cárcel por andar echando mentiras y acusando gente que no debe. Eso yo ya lo perdoné y perdoné a todos los que me hicieron mal.
Yes.
Pero me siento bien, gracias a Dios, y con ansia de seguir adelante en la música y con ansia de volver a cantar. Y estoy muy desesperado porque ahorita I'm pending on the DA signs aquí de Luis Sainz de Bronx or Cameron County to move forward with the DNA testing. Mm-hmm. We have done all he has asked. And basically, we've been waiting for months, and for some reason, he goes back to home back. And this, ya pasé otro polygraph exam que me dieron.
Oh, that's awesome.
This is number four.
Wow.
And I passed in todos los pasados. And then the most recent guy have been that discharged the sexual treatment class programs.
Okay.
Es algo que me dejaron salir porque ya no me lo dieron porque no lo merezco estar ahí. And they already know that I mean, esto del estado, the state is the one que te manda hacer eso. So, todo se ve a mi lado, nomás que por ciertas personas no me quieren dar la libertad.
And so now, okay, now let's repeat that. You've been officially discharged from the sexual assault counseling, is it? Is that correct?
Sí, es un sexual treatment program.
Okay, sexual treatment program.
A los que hacen, sex offenders.
Uh-huh.
And it's in a class. And they discharged me from it because they know that I'm not like that. And they know that I'm not a sexual offender or anything,
uh-huh.
So they can't teach me anything. So ya se dieron cuenta que lo que me hicieron a mí was a false accusation, wrongfully convicted.
Now
that I'm not one for them to be treating me this way and tratándome como un criminal, which I'm not.
Okay, now you said that this is your fourth lie detector test that you've taken. Now, is this stuff ordered by the state, and is it admissible in court to bring one step closer to your official 100% exoneration and freedom?
Pues todo esto es parte, ¿verdad? Porque polygraph son te estás diciendo que estoy diciendo la verdad, te hacen preguntas como que si has estado con menores de edad, que si he tenido con la familia, alguna familiar, y todo lo pasé los cuatro que me han dado. Así es que No, yo no entiendo por qué todavía quieren acusarme y tenerme aquí, ¿verdad? Pero gracias a Dios que ya estoy afuera, ya no más estoy esperando que se pase esto y el DA que salga con la verdad, and I'll be out of here.
Now, let me ask you this. Is it a financial thing for these people to step forward and hurry up and handle this case? I mean, because if so, we can open up a GoFundMe account or try to do some fundraiser events to help you. Because, you know, you have all the documentation. You have all the proof already at hand. Sandra's done one hell of a job by going to Austin and making all that noise to bring in a step closer to your 100% freedom. Is there something that fans or business owners or anybody that can do to help these guys out to hurry up and get this process done?
Well, Casper, I'll speak on behalf of that. And it's not about resources. What we have been waiting for is the DA.
Okay.
Our attorneys, the DA came out about 4 months ago and said, on national TV, that he would rightfully liberate someone who was wrongfully convicted if our attorneys were to submit the proper paperwork. We have done so, and we are still patiently waiting.
Mm-hmm.
We want the DA to be on board with us because we want this to be a joint effort to clear Joe's name, and we're trying to patiently wait for him to move forward. It's not about resources right now.
Mm-hmm.
It's about getting the DNA testing done. We know that that DNA testing that got Joe convicted is going to be the same DNA testing that's going to liberate him. But we need to get it tested. There have been agreements on all levels.
Mm-hmm.
Rancho Viejo Police Department, with our attorneys. Everybody's on the board, but we're just waiting for the DA.
Now, let me ask you this, Sandra. Is there any more of the dirty people that did this to Joe still active out here right now? I don't know if you can speak on that behalf there, disclose that information. But is there somebody that's keeping this from going forward?
Oh, I can guarantee you that there is someone that's keeping this from going forward. And the reason I say that is because we have unraveled and revealed a lot of information, a lot of dirtiness that was done, misconduct that was done on all levels on Joe's case.
Mm-hmm.
And there are a lot of people that don't want this to come out. But you know what? God is greater than everybody, Casper.
Oh, yes. Mm-hmm.
And because of God, this is all coming out, and it's landing in our lap. So for those individuals who play a big role in making a decision, I say this to you tonight. As you go to bed, think about what you have done to Joe Lopez.
Mm-hmm.
And tomorrow morning when you wake up, do the right thing.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's not Joe that you have to answer to, it's the man upstairs.
Mm-hmm.
And if I see you in church every Sunday, I know that you have to have a heart.
Mm-hmm.
So I say to you, it's time. Justice will prevail, but it's time for this nightmare to be over.
Mm-hmm.
And the only person that's carrying this in their arm is our district attorney,
mm-hmm.
Louise Stein. We're asking you to do the right thing, not for Joe, but for everybody in Brownsville.
Now, is there any information that maybe we can sign petitions to get this cleared once and for all? I mean, it's been, now Joe's been out, actually out from prison, almost a year, I believe, right?
That is correct. March 15th will be 1 year. We're just a day shy of 11 months.
Okay. And so is there any possible way that we can reach out to this DA and sign petitions and say, hey, man, ponte ser algo ese. I mean, man, we need Joe back. I mean, give him his freedom back. Give him his life back. Is there anything that the public can do to help Joe in this case?
I urge the public to do so now, especially now that Joe has passed the polygraph again,
mm-hmm.
Especially now that he's been discharged by a state sex therapist from the sex treatment program. Yes, I urge everyone out there in the Tejano industry to pick up your phone and to call District Louise Sines and to tell him to do the right thing. It's time. It's time. Pick up the phone and call Senator Lucio and ask him to review the laws of sex offenders and to make a change.
Okay.
That's why he's in our district.
Mm-hmm.
That's why everyone voted for him to be where he's at.
Mm-hmm. Well, is there any information? Well, maybe I'll talk to you more about that after we get off the air. You can give me all that information so we can go ahead and share it on all our social media outlets and website as well. And, I'll personally, make the attempt to share to all our radio affiliates. And so, I mean, all the online stations that I know there's a lot of them that are listening on this broadcast tonight, and it's very special and informative to let our fans and listeners know that, it's still a battle, it's sad to see, but golly, man, what are these people thinking? If Joe's already done everything that he has done and he's still being prevented and he's still keeping, he's being kept from society. I mean, there has to be something done. There's no other way to it. We need to step up, all the fans and listeners, we need to step up and do something for you, Joe.
Yes, and Casper, there's another thing that I wanted to say on behalf of the Texas Parole Office in Harlingen. Joe is up for review,
mm-hmm.
March 15th.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone that released is up for annual review after the year.
Mm-hmm.
We're praying that when they review Joe's case, I have to tell you, that Joe has been very compliant
mm-hmm.
in every aspect of his parole. He has done everything he has been asked to do. And with that being said, they look at all that.
Mm-hmm.
No violation. Hopefully, with the grace of God, the monitor will be coming off and Joe will have a little more freedom. We won't be free until we're exonerated, but at least he'll be able to breathe a little bit more.
Mm-hmm.
So, we ask that everybody pray for Joe. March 15th is the annual review. And we pray to God that his parole officer and the leaders that make this decision look at Joe's case and look at who he is as a person. I want to take this minute real quick, Casper.
Go ahead.
Joe has no clue that I'm going to do this right now, but Joe has never been thanked. He has had to walk the path of a very, very hard, long path these last 11 months. And Joe, I thank you for believing in me, for never once doubting that what I was doing right and just to get your freedom. I'm so very proud of you for being the person that you are today. I can only not even imagine what you went through the last 12 years. But I'm so grateful to God for him to give you the strength that it has taken for you to walk these last 11 months through this trail of misery, tribulation, and finally timely pain that you have in your heart. Thank you so much, and I ask God to continue to give you the strength to finish our mission to get you exonerated.
Thank you. Thank you, Sarah. And thank you very much for everything. This is a surprise, but it is true. And I thank God, first of all, he is the one, the Most High God, he's the one that does everything for us. And all I got to do is have faith and keep praying every night, every day. And I pray to God every day that none of this or what they did to me would happen to anybody else. And I want to have that is something horrible. And what else can I say? Justice will prevail, and I want to be part of this organization one day to be able to talk to families and people and protect the young Mexicanos out there, the young Tejanos.
Now, Joe, we want to say thank you for giving us this opportunity also to share something that's very important in your life, and that the Lord continues, you know, with his blessings. I know he has his hand placed over you. I know he has something special for you. And right now it seems like it's going to take forever, pero lo bueno es que ya estás con nosotros. And ya falta poco para que se arregle todo esto, porque ya es mucho. And so... I mean, Diosito es grande, y primeramente Dios, te vamos a ver en los escenarios. We're going to see you back on the stages. Now, can you disclose any information as far as, I know we got a lot of Joe Lopez fans anxious. You know, we got the people from the TTMA also listening, the president. We got everybody, Mr. Arellano. We got, of course, Bino G also listening. Everybody, the whole staff at TTMA.
That's really something else. Es algo muy grande para mí que todavía esta gente piense de mí y hablen de mí y me tengan en sus pensamientos.
And you know, Casper, I do have something out there special that I would like to say. Mm-hmm. First and foremost, I would like to thank Robert Arellano, the president, Frank Salazar, the vice president, and Dino G, event coordinator. The TTMA 2019 fanfare. Joe and myself are very, very pleased to be able to be a part of such a beautiful, awesome event that's going to be happening March 14th through the 17th. I do have to say, Joe Lopez Mod will have a live broadcast on Friday, March 15th, the main stage. And if it wasn't for these lovely, lovely individuals that allowed us to be a part of the 2019 fanfare, we wouldn't be a part of it. So a special shout out to all of you guys, and we really, really take that to heart. Joe and I are very, very grateful. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Do you guys remember now? Well, I know Joe didn't remember, but the first time that we met, Sandra, you were standing with Lorenzo. I was driving around with my crew from Tejano Whoopass TV, and we stopped, and we made an actual, we filmed these guys, and that was the question: when is Joe coming back? And we talked about it right then and there. You know, it's like, man, and you had already gave us like an insight. Well, you know, hopefully next year. Well, this actually happened 2 years ago, and well, it didn't happen last year. But isn't this awesome? Isn't this incredible to know that your prediction was that he was going to be able to be back in time for the Tejano Music Awards fanfare. And, you know, this is going to be an awesome surprise to all our fans and listeners. And so how does it feel, the prediction actually now being even closer and even now more real than a couple years ago?
Well, you know, Casper, 2 years ago, I was just beginning to work on Joe's case. And, you know, when I took Joe's case, my heart told me that I was doing the right thing and that Joe was an innocent man. And I just always continued to think that and feel that with my heart. I have a beautiful angel in heaven that is my daddy, who I lost a year ago. And he would tell me every day, when is he coming home? Are you bringing him home? And I tell you what, he's the one that has allowed me the strength to continue to fight every day, because it has been a challenge. But you know what, Casper? To be able to hear that we are going to be a part of the 2019 fanfare is very dear to my heart, because I knew that one day, very near, Joe would be a free man. And it brings tears to my eyes today, because one day he will be on that stage and he will be able to say, hello, whatever city we're in. And you know what? It's very, very close. And that is what I reach for, because that is when I completed my mission of freeing Joe Lopez.
That is awesome. There are no words that can express the excitement. And I know there's a lot of fans and listeners out there that are tuned in to hear this. And again, thanks to the TTMA for making this possible. And I myself, man, I'm just like a nervous wreck right now. Anything else, Joe, that you want to disclose? Lo que quieras decir ahorita, you know, like, you know how we did it before. Open mic. Lo que tú quieres decir, mandar saludos and shout outs y todo eso. I mean, step up to the mic right about this time, in other words, and give us your final thoughts and words before we head on out of here tonight.
Gracias, Casper, and gracias a tu radio, de Habla Radio, y las gracias de todo primero que nada a Dios, porque sin Dios no, nada de esto sería cabo. Y luego mi gente, todos mis fans, a través de los años me han estado soportando, mandándome cartas every day to the prison where they had me. Mm-hmm. And nunca dejaron de pensar de mí, y eso me trae mucho orgullo, y mi música sigue pegando donde quiera y la sigue tocando, y estoy muy orgulloso de estar aquí y poder hablar contigo a través de la radio, y a todos los las escuchas que nos están escuchando. Goes out to all my fans, and happy Valentine's Day, and please stay alive and be somebody.
Joe, can we get you to sing a few verses of the song Vuelvo?
I don't know. Right now, I don't feel like it. I don't.
But come on, man, just a little bit. The first part.
Of what?
Of the song Vuelvo. Because that's like your Vuelvo. Iconic. Yeah, that's like your iconic song right there. I mean, I play that song all the time, and golly, you see everybody throwing gritos and taking shots and filling up the dance floors. Just a little bit, brother.
Okay. Hasta el fin, mi amor. Vuelvo a estar contigo.
Sas.
Yay!
Joe Lopez coming back real soon, Rosita. Muchísimas gracias, hermano. Thank you so much, Sandra. Any last words, Sandra, before we head on out of here?
Thank you.
Okay, Raza. Well, hey, check it out, Raza. We got some more music. I'm going to be jamming out for a little bit for a few minutes right here on TejanoOutlawRadio.com. Muchísimas gracias once again for tuning in right here. And there you have it, a worldwide exclusive interview number 2 right here with the legendary icon, the king of Tejano music, Joe Lopez, Grupo Mas, right here on TejanoOutlawRadio.com. We'll be right back. going out to all of you once again. Thanks for hanging out with us right here live on DanoOutlawRadio.com. It's your boy DJ Casper hanging out with you. Thank you to all our fans on Facebook Live who tuned in and checked out the broadcast. Thank you. Thank you so much for all the great support. Y mucho más. We got a couple more jams right here. Happy Valentine's Day. Shout outs going out to all of you once again. Biggest Surprise. That's right. You heard it first right here. Show Lopez with a special surprise for the TTMA 2019 Fanfare in San Antonio, Texas.
Que se robe otra mujer, todo este amor, lo que siento yo por ti. No quiero que te robe otra mujer, lo que por ti yo conocí. Si quieres que yo sea tu querer, decídelo, porque hay otra que busca mi querer, y vas a ver que tú vas a perder. No quiero que te robe otra mujer, todo este amor que vive para ti. No quiero que te robe otra mujer, lo que por ti yo conocí. Si quieres ser la dueña de mi amor, decídelo, porque hay otra que busca mi calor y va a robar también mi corazón.
Thank you to everybody on Facebook Live. Right about this time, we have Ms. Sandra Vallejo, who's joining us on Facebook. Thank you for all the great comments, everybody, to all of you. Joe Lopez fans, of course. Happy Valentine's Day. Thank you, Joe Lopez. Muchísimas gracias. I even got Joe Lopez to sing a little verse.
Que te robe otra mujer, todo este amor, lo que siento yo por ti. No quiero que te robe otra mujer, lo que por ti yo conocí. Si quieres que yo sea tu querer, decídelo, porque hay otra que busca mi querer. Y vas a ver que tú vas a perder.
DanoOutlawRadio.com. Playing the best in town of music, mucho más. Still hanging out with you right here. Joe Lopez, thank you so very much.
Muy feliz, con alegría. Una pena que ensuciara este amor. Queda tan lindo despertarme cada día.
Shout outs going out to Tia Mary Cantu. Thank you, Tia. Julia Castro, happy Valentine's Day. Terry Lopez, he said, I love Joe Lopez.
A mi lado, bien lo sabes. De todo aquello, tú eras toda la razón. Yo no comprendo el por qué me abandonaste, dejando solo una huella con tu adiós. La cicatriz que me causaste al herirme, con ese vidrio del olvido de tu amor, me ha dejado para siempre en la vida, mancha del alma y marcado el corazón. La cicatriz que me causaste al herirme, con ese vidrio del olvido de
de tu amor me ha dejado para siempre en la vida, mancha del alma y marcado el corazón. Mientras te tuve a mi lado, bien lo sabes, de todo aquello tú eras toda la razón. Yo no comprendo el por qué me abandonaste, dejando solo una huella con tu adiós. La cicatriz que me causaste al herirme, con ese vidrio del olvido de tu amor, me ha dejado para siempre en la vida, mancha del alma y marcado el corazón. La cicatriz que me causaste al herirme, con ese vidrio del olvido de tu amor, me ha dejado para siempre en la vida, mancha del alma y marcado el corazón. Hasta el fin, mi amor.
That's right, the legendary icon. The king of Tejano music, Mr. Joe Lopez. I got him to sing the first part of this song. How badass is that shit? You know what I'm saying?
Porque solo tú es a quien yo quiero.
Thank you for tuning in, Raza. I'll be logging off after this song right here. Gotta go get my Valentine freak on. DJ Casper from Dallas, Texas, hanging out with you right here.
Vuelvo porque no he encontrado a nadie como tú, porque nadie más me supo acariciar de esta manera como lo hacías tú. Y hasta hoy no te he podido olvidar. No he dejado de pensar ni de soñar, y eso es porque he decidido en volver. Es que quiero que me quieras como nunca me has querido, que sientas tú conmigo lo que yo siento contigo. Dame un poquitito más, no te dejaré jamás, mi amor. Es que quiero que me quieras como nunca me has querido, y que sientas tú conmigo lo que yo siento contigo. Dame un poquitito más, no te dejaré jamás, mi amor. Vuelvo porque no he encontrado a nadie como tú, porque nadie más me supo acariciar de esa manera como lo hacías tú. Y hasta hoy no te he podido olvidar. No he dejado de pensar ni de soñar, y eso es porque he decidido en volver. Es que quiero que me quieras como nunca me has querido, y que sientas tú conmigo lo que yo siento contigo. Dame un poquitito más, no te dejaré jamás, mi amor.
conmigo lo que yo siento contigo. Dame un poquitito más, no te dejaré jamás, mi amor. Es que quiero que me quieras como nunca me has querido, y que sientas tú conmigo lo que yo siento contigo. Dame un poquitito más, no te dejaré jamás, mi amor.
Once again, thank you for joining us right here on a very special broadcast on Valentine's Day. Thank you to Joe Lopez. Thank you to Sandra Vallejo. Till the next time, gracita. Se me cuidan mucho.
Follow us everywhere. BlackBerry, iPhone, Twitter, Facebook, YouTube. And on your computer
24/7.
We are everywhere you are.
TejanoOutlawRadio.com. Where else can you hear all the elements of music but on Tejano Outlaw Radio? Don't forget to download the free app today, TejanoOutlawRadio.com. We are on 24/7.
All day.